Chapter 21, A Mysterious Disappearance. The hour approached 11 when Mr. Parker and his daughter presented themselves at the Seville Hotel. Miss Harmon and her maid had returned from the theater only a few minutes earlier. "We are sorry to disturb you," Mr. Parker apologized, "but something important has come up. Will you see us in the lobby?" "Yes," agreed the dancer. "I will join you immediately." The three sought a secluded alcove where their conversation would not be overheard. "What has occurred?" Miss Harmon asked, noticing Mr. Parker's sober countenance. "This will prove a shock, I fear," he replied. "Something has happened to your brother." "Yes? Has he been arrested?" "It's more serious than that," Mr. Parker returned quietly. "Your brother has vanished." The information stunned Miss Harper, and for a moment she made no response. Then, struggling for control, she said, "Please don't keep me in suspense. Tell me just what happened." To Mr. Parker's account of the seance and the resulting events, she listened in amazement and horror. "Oh, how dreadful," she murmured. "Melvin was afraid something might happen to him. He feared for his life." "Did he have any known enemies?" questioned Mr. Parker. "Not to my knowledge, but ever since Melvin received that strange warning, he has had a premonition of harm that would befall him." "Had the police no clues?" "A very slender one," Mr. Parker returned. "We hope that you might be able to throw light on the situation. You are certain your brother had no enemies?" "He did have one person who hated him," the dancer said, speaking slowly. "But that was so long ago, and the man's in prison now." "Tell us about it," urged Mr. Parker. "While my brother and I were living in New York with our parents, this man stole money from father. Melvin secured proof of it and had him arrested. He was tried and, largely due to the testimony of Melvin and myself, sentenced to 15 years in prison." "How long ago was that?" inquired Penny. "Not more than 7 years. The man would still be in prison. He couldn't have had nothing to do with Melvin's disappearance." "It does seem very unlikely," agreed Mr. Parker. "What was the fellow's name?" "Ivan Lavelle." "Lavelle!" exclaimed the newspaper owner. "Why, haven't you heard? He escaped from the penitentiary about 6 months ago and was never captured." "No!" "Of course, that doesn't prove that Lavelle had anything to do with your brother's disappearance," Mr. Parker went on. "In fact, the evidence rather points towards the hunchback assistants who aided your brother." "Could you tell us anything about Spider?" Penny interposed. "I knew very little about him. My brother engaged him some months ago when his regular assistant entered a different line of work." "Your brother trusted him?" questioned Mr. Parker. "I feel certain he did. It occurred to me that Ivan Lavelle might have passed himself off as Spider," Penny declared thoughtfully. "Apparently such wasn't the case." "Oh, I knew Lavelle well," Miss Harmon said. "He did not resemble Spider in any respect." Penny and her father talked for a few minutes longer with the dancer, learning only one additional fact of interest. Melvin O'Sandra and Spider both had known and made use of the secret exit from the seance parlor. To Miss Harmon's knowledge, no other persons had shared in this information. "The police are doing everything in their power to trace your brother," Mr. Parker comforted the young woman. "I have confidence he will be found soon." "I blame myself for all that has happened," Miss Harmon murmured self-accusingly. "If I had told the truth in the first place, this dreadful act might not have been prevented." Penny assisted the dancer to her room, turning her over to the care of the maid, and then returned to the lobby. "We didn't learn a great deal," Mr. Parker commented. "However, there may be more to this Ivan Lavelle affair than Miss Harmon suspects. I wonder if the police have a picture of the man." "Unquestionably, Penny. For that matter, I imagine we have one in the Star's morgue. I'll run down there now and see. Do you mind going home alone?" "Not at all. You take the car and I'll ride the bus home, her father said. If it's too late for you to be on the streets. Mr. Parker escorted Penny to the automobile, waving goodbye as she drove away. The night was dark. She had not gone many blocks before a heavy rain began to fall. During the past weeks, there had been several storms. Penny was tired of such unseasonable weather. She snapped on the windshield wipers, thinking of her father, who did not even have the protection of a raincoat. Passing the Seidel residence, which was dark, Penny drove on towards home, her thoughts turning from the events of the evening to Nellie Marble. She wondered what the girl had started to tell her at the Schlosser cottage. Who could have thrown the rock through the window? The longer Penny reflected upon the situation, the more firmly she became convinced that Nellie could explain many baffling matters if only she chose to. To all appearances, there was no connection between the witch doll happenings and Melvin Ostrander's strange disappearance. Yet the girl had a feeling that such a relationship might exist. She made up her mind. She would make another attempt to win Nellie's confidence. Upon turning into the driveway, Penny observed the lights were burning on the upper floors, evidence that someone was still awake. "I hope Nellie isn't ill," she thought anxiously. She left the car in the garage and, without taking time to lock the doors, hastened into the house. "Is that you, Penny?" called the housekeeper from the second floor. "Yes, Mrs. Weems. Dad went back to the office, so I came home alone." "I'm so relieved you're here, Penny." "I waited up for you. Is anything wrong? Nellie isn't feeling worse." When Mrs. Weems did not reply, Penny ran up the steps two at a time. A light burnt in the guest room. She moved to the door, which stood half open. The room was deserted. "Mrs. Weems, where are you?" Penny said anxiously. "What has happened to Nellie?" Do, 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 do.